Sports of Duquesne University WPIAL Basketball Championships joined here in progress. The Shadyside Indians and the Shenango Wildcats tied at 8 with 3 minutes to play here in the first quarter. My name is Sean Daugherty, and Shadyside takes the lead at 10-8. Damian McGill getting his first bucket of the game for the Indians. Indians in white, Wildcats from Shenango in blue. Shadyside with a 21-5 record coming back into this game, the finals, after losing to the finals last year against the Rocks and going on to win the state championship. They no longer have Pete Sauer in their lineup, and they do have his younger brother, Alex. And Shenango's in this game for the first time in a long time. They're 24-1 overall, just one loss up in their section to a tough Farrell team who lost to Shadyside in the semifinals, 61-51. First foul of the game goes against number 15 for the Indians. That's on number 15. We don't have a 15 on the floor. We put the wrong foul on the board. The foul against double zero, Damian McGill for Shadyside Academy. The first foul against the Indians. The shot is up and good. Both shot, foul shots made good by Ryan Delaney for Shenango. And we're tied at 10. We'll be back with more of the Class A Championship right after this. Attended the AA Championship here at the A.J. Palumbo Center on the campus of Duquesne University. Shadyside Academy in the home white, Shenango Wildcats in the visiting blue. The Indians, that's Brian McGill, number 10. We'll start with Alex Sauer, number 41 on the near side. He has it now. Inside to Carl Sipp, 54. And McGill will go down, not McGill, that's Ryan Wilkins, number 10. Dished inside to Sipp, and he's up and good with the foul. He'll go to the line to try to make a three-point play and give the Indians a three-point lead. The other starter is double zero for Shadyside Academy, Damian McGill. The starters for Shenango, Shane Lanigan wears 15. David Barody, number 20. Ryan Kaufman, 22. James Graham, 24. And Ryan Delaney, 25. Graham, an 19-point per game score, 7.5 rebounds. Lanigan, 17.5 a game. And two big scores for Shenango. Now Delaney averages 13 rebounds a game inside. That rebound, though, came to Ryan Kaufman, and Shenango goes back on offense, trailing by two. 2:11 to play here, first quarter in the Class A championship game. We've already crowned champions in the Duquesne High Dukes and the Blackhawk Cougars, and we'll have the Quad A championship coming up at 6 o'clock following this one right here on Prime Sports. Air ball up and no good, so a turnover to the Indians, and Alex Sauer and Brian Wilkins will try to get Shadyside's offense rolling here again with 1:48 to play in the first quarter. Wilkins on the wing, that's double zero. Damian McGill, big game in their semifinal win over Farrells. He scored 21 points, 11 points over his average. And no call there despite the collision at midcourt. Inside to Delaney, up and strong. He's going to power it up again. Not there. And Sipp's going to grab the rebound for Shadyside. Game getting a little crazy here with 1:21 to play in the quarter as the ball goes out of bounds. And the foul called against Shadyside's number 41, Alex Sauer. His first, his second against the Indians in the game. Haven't missed much. Ryan Kaufman and James Graham both hit three-pointers from Shenango early, after Shadyside jumped out to an early four-point lead, but those threes took care of that in a hurry. Our first substitution of the game has number 12, Jarius Acey, in for Shadyside Academy Indians, 5'9" freshman. And he's matched up with Shane Lanigan. Lanigan handles outside for Shenango. Minute to play in the quarter. Three-point attempt up and short by David Barody. Saved in nicely by Kaufman, but the Indians get it instead. And here comes Acey, the freshman. Got away with a walk, but Carl Sipp with the emphatic dunk as Shadyside up to a 14-10 lead. He has 8 points already in the game, 8 of Shadyside's 14. Sipp off to a good start for the Indians. He averages almost 20 points a game. But Lanigan is an offensive machine himself. He gets the hoop there and draws the foul. Take a look at that. Look at the pass from AC. You didn't see, but it looked like he took an extra hop, but it was a great look. And of course, Sip with the good finish for the Indians. The foul called against number 50 for the Indians. They don't have a number. Oh, there it is. Charlie Galo, 6'5", senior center. That's him with the basketball, just in the game and already in the book with his first foul. Shadyside leads at 14-13 with the basketball. AC outside in three-point range. Sauer for three. Alex Sauer, just a junior, and that's the end of the first quarter. And a good one it was for the Shadyside Indians as they lead Shenango 17-13 after 8 minutes of play in the Class AA Championship. That's the story so far here at the A.J. Palumbo Center at Duquesne University. Shadyside with 17 points in the first quarter, 12 of those coming inside, 8 of them by Carl Sipp, who's off to a great start for Shadyside. Of course, the three-pointer at the buzzer, just before the buzzer by Alex Sauer, has them up to a four-point lead. The three-point attempt by James Graham, not there, and the Indians back on offense, looking to widen that lead if they can. Chris Kane down the baseline, forces it a bit, has it blocked nicely by Coughlin, but gets his own rebound and gets on the board for the first time tonight. No, wrong about that. That's 6 points for Kane. A little clueless here as we're kind of starting on the run, joined in progress, and hope you enjoyed that Atlantic 10 game. We've got another big high school game coming up for you right after this one on Prime Sports. Sauer up, headband Kane, and he was fouled pretty hard. I think it's going to go against Shenango's 24, James Graham. If so, it'll be his second and third foul against the Wildcats here in the first half. Substitutions for Shenango, number 21, Matt Allison, and number 34, Jason Gergerina, will be in. And we come back after this commercial break. Actually, we're not taking a break, they tell me. Timeout called by Shenango head coach Bill McNeese. 7-12 to play here in the first half of the game. Shenango down by 6 and does not want Shadyside to open up a bigger lead. Both teams playing man-to-man early here. A little tougher matchups for the smaller Shenango team. Gergerina at 6'1" into the lineup. Along with Allison, who is also 6'1". A little more even size, but they don't really have any big guys in the Shenango roster. Shadyside Academy, on the other hand, of course, Carl Sipp at 6'5", and McGill listed at 6'8". He'll go on to play at Lehigh next season. Has had a problem with. Let's take a look. And I know I've been running them kind of bad. But it won't be the same Shenango lineup that you see right there. Okay. Art Humphrey's giving me first quarter stats here. Sipp, of course, leads everybody with 8 points in the game. Coughlin and Graham with a three-pointer each. Delaney leads with 4 points for the Shenango Wildcats. Jarius Acey, the freshman from Shadyside at the point. Alex Sauer, his second three-point attempt. He's 2 for 2, and the Indians are out to a 21-22-13 lead. He has 6 points. Lanigan handling it offensively. They swing it around. 21 is Matt Allison. Lanigan outside. 34, Gergerina. A little bit of a weave action against the Shadyside man-to-man outside. Trying to see if they can't pop the big guy open inside. Shadyside with Carl Sipp getting a rest here. After jumping out with 8 first quarter points, getting a good rest here 6 minutes in the second quarter. First half action here at the A.J. Palumbo Center. Double-A championship. Three-point attempt up by Graham. I think Kane got a piece of that one. Lanigan inside. Draws the foul. It's going to go against Shadyside's number 50, Charlie Gayo. The 6'5 senior center. That's his second foul. That's four fouls against the Indians in the game so far. And there you see number 54, Carl Sipp, back into the Indians lineup along with number 10, Brian Wilkins. Chris Kane sits down along with Gayo. Try to go inside to 25 to 80. Can't get it there, but there is a foul called. He did manage to draw the foul against double zero. Damian McGill, his second. So we'll see if Coach Alex Housen of the Indians wants to stick with him. We've got a long way to go here in the first half, and he's already not in foul trouble, but a lot of coaches, you see, will make that move to let a guy sit a little bit so they don't get into trouble in the first half. Pretty shot there for Shane Lanigan as he went to his left. And cuts that lead to 22-15. Sauer from the baseline. In and out, but then followed by McGill for Shadyside. And he has 4 points in the game. The 6'8" guy. There's a lot of room to work inside. Tall and gangly a bit. As you see the knee brace on his right leg, had some problems with his knee in the offseason last year, but he's had a good year for the Indians. And as I said, will attend Lehigh University next season, playing Division I basketball. Shenango down by nine, needs a hoop here with 4:45 to play in the half. Go in the middle. And a pretty shot by Ryan Delaney as he got it up over the bigger Shadyside defenders for the hoop. 7 point game. Shenango, it looks like a 3-2 or 2-1-2 zone. Now they're matched up man-to-man. Kind of a zone maybe with matchup principles. Now they're playing more. The Sauer comes around. And picked clean by Shane Lanigan. Jump switch and he made the steal. And gets Shenango back within five. Seven points in the game for Lanigan. He leads Shenango, 7-19. There's a foul called against Shenango. With 3:50 to play. It's gonna go against number 34, Jason Gargarina. And so with that, folks, and the score, 24-19, Shadyside with the lead and the basketball. We'll be back to the Palumbo Center in just a minute. There's a story, as you see it. WPIAL Championship Basketball is being brought to you by Computer Tech, where you earn a specialized associate's degree in just 18 months. Alex Sauer set the inbound for the Shadyside Indians. They lead it 24-19. Chris Kane back into the lineup for the Shadyside. He wears 34. Also in for Shadyside is number 32, Byron Ayers, a 6'2 junior. But there's the three-pointer, the third of the night for Alex Sauer. And he's off to a 9-point start. And Shadyside up to a 27-19 lead. Graham working against Chris Kane. Lanigan. Outside. He'll go inside. Delaney working against Sip. Down the lane, left-handed shot. Pretty left-handed hook. Off the glass and good. And Shenango is matching up well inside against the taller Shadyside Indians. Byron Ayers, number 34. They'll get it inside Sip. Double pump, a little strong, but Kane was there for the rebound. And there is a foul. It's going to go against James Graham, number 24 for Shenango. That was a toughie. I couldn't tell whether Graham maybe or Kane had a hold of Graham. Instead, that's five fouls against Shenango. Both teams with five. 2.5 minutes to play here in the first half. 27-21. Shadyside leads it with the basketball. Kane working outside. Number 10, Brian Wilkins. Kane right down the lane. Had this shot blocked nicely by Ryan Delaney. Get another look at this. Kane goes hard to the rack right here. Kane only averaging about 12 points a game, but doesn't has had some big games in the playoffs down the stretch. ...66% foul shooter, he makes one out of two, and the Indians have a 28-21 lead. Lanigan back for Shenango. A foul called against Shadyside. Foul called against number 10, Brian Wilkins for the Indians. His first, that's six against Shadyside, so still nobody goes to the line to shoot one and one. Delaney in the middle, up and off the rim. Put the tip up and not in there, and Shadyside clears it. Here comes Kane. On the run, Indians moving. Alex Sauer. Kane down the middle, as it's knocked away by Lanigan from the backside, and it's knocked out of bounds. Chris Kane was laying on the out of bounds line when he touched it. So it'll go back to Shenango. The Wildcats trailing by seven. Not used to losing, just one loss this season. There's a long way to go here in this WPIAL championship on Prime Sports. Sean Daugherty here, courtside with you. As the shot is up and hard off the rim by Graham. He made a three-pointer early, but he's missed his last two attempts. And a travel called on Ryan Delaney. So the Wildcats blow an opportunity and turn it right back over to the Shadyside Indians. 1:32 to play here in the first half. They lead it 28-21. Sauer and Wilkins at the guards. Kane on the wing. Shot up and good, and the Indians really on the road. Carl Sipp with 10 points as they're on a roll, leading it 30-21. With a minute to play here in the first half. Approaching a minute, as you see. The bottom right-hand corner of your screen. A little trouble there, a Sauer cutoff rarity as he went into the lane, but outside for the three, he gets it back and misses everything. Kane will come out, and the Indians have errors down court. Can he save it? He does, but Delaney has it for Shenango. Two on three, it might be best to pull it up instead. Kane forces the turnover, and Shenango gets it back. Or the Indians get it back, Shadyside does. With 44 seconds left in this first half. The Shenango cheerleaders. Both teams blue and gold. Shadyside in the visiting white, or the home white, I should say, here tonight. Good drive into the lane by Ayers. That was a shot blocked nicely by Delaney. And recovers and tries to do the pass. It goes out of bounds. And it was knocked out by number 22, Ryan Kaufman. So Shadyside will stay in control with 28 seconds left in the half. See if Coach Housen wants to hold for one shot here. As the ball goes out of bounds again with 25. Sauer hit the three-pointer to end the first quarter. We'll see if the Indians try to set him up here again. He'll inbound from the corner. Jarius Acey, the freshman, tries to go down the lane, and Lanigan likes that cheap steal type action from the back, reaching around, and second time he's knocked the ball away, but that one back to Shadyside, 22 now on the clock. Acey outside. Sauer on the wing, over the baseline. It gets open, but can't get the shot as he was too far under the hoop. We'll try it again and have it blocked by Delaney. So with 8 seconds to go, the Wildcats have to hurry, but they have a shot at a point here. Rarity to the forecourt. Graham fires a three, a double pump three, and it's no good. So at the end of the first half of play, the Shadyside Academy Indians have a 30-21 lead over the Shenango Wildcats. This is your Class AA championship on Prime Sports. Here courtside at the A.J. Palumbo Center, the campus of Duquesne University, where the Shadyside Indians have a 30-21 lead over the Shenango Wildcats at halftime, and we're about ready to get through some halftime stats. Dan, if you could give us the scoring leaders, and I'm sure we'll have the rest of the things coming up here in just a second.
Sean, individual stats for Shadyside. Sip leads with 10. Kane has chipped in with 7, and Sauer on the 3 three-pointers with 9. For Shenango, Delaney leads with 8. Lanigan chipped in with 7. There you see the team stats, and the thing that sticks out right away is a field goal percentage. Shenango only 31%. Graham's only 1 for 7 from 3-point range.
Averaging
rebounds,
eight,
a little bit of a edge to Shadyside. Most of their points in the first half have come in the paint. 18 points in the paint for Shadyside.
And they have done it well inside. We're about ready to get started here in the second half. The Indians will have the basketball to start it and a 9-point lead. Alex Sauer, 41, 34, Chris Kane. Number 10 is Brian Wilkins. The big men inside, 54, Carl Sipp and 00, Damian McGill. Shenango starts with their starting lineup, 24, James Graham, matched up with Kane. 15, Shane Lanigan on Wilkins. And the inside guys, 25, Ryan Delaney. 22, Ryan Kaufman, and number 20, David Verratti for the Shenango Wildcats. You see a big rebound there for Sip off the backside off the miss, and McGill follows, does not get the roll on that, but he does draw a foul. Foul called on Ryan Kaufman for Shenango. Obviously the first of the half. Doubles, it's Kaufman's first. Damian McGill at the line. 1 for 2, it's a 31-21 Shadyside lead. Lanigan off quickly, and the guards are gonna have to get it. It was going early here. John Sikora talked about it. And there's Verratti with the three-pointer. The third of the game.
Nice job by Lanigan pulling up. He didn't have the numbers, backed it out, just waited for the rest of his teammates to get there, and they get a big hoop.
Ball knocked out of bounds by Shadyside's Brian Wilkins. Not knocked out by Shadyside's Brian Wilkins, instead knocked out by Lanigan. So Shadyside in control. This is Chris Kane to Wilkins. And McGill. Little give and go. Chris Kane loses it on the baseline, turns it over. So Shenango trying to build a little momentum after the big three-pointer from Ryan Kaufman.
So question about the ball being used, Sean. I think that each team uses
their own
selector ball for a half, and the Shenango bench is a little bit upset. They're saying that the ball wasn't switched, and it's obviously their choice this half as to which ball to use. So that's what they're doing right now.
Exactly. I don't know what, can't imagine what the difference is.
I tell you what.
It's funny, I happened to be at the pairings meeting, and when the rules were being laid out, they talked about this, and the comment was that now the officials are fighting with Coach McNeese, saying, no, we got the right ball here. But anyhow, saying, you know, John Miller from Blackhawk, of course, won the AAA championship last year. His big thing is, well, we'll use any ball you got. Let's just throw it up and play.
And it was cleaned up. The Shenango bench was mistaken. They did use their ball the first half. That's enough. Let's quit talking about which ball we're using.
That's the case. By the way, I don't know. I like this ball. They should like it. They got the three to go.
Hit a three with it.
Inside, Delaney will try the baseline and back it out to Lanigan. Back in, the two-man game. And the big fella goes up over Damian McGill, but doesn't get the roll, and Sip clears the rebound. And a nice tip from Alex Sauer. Kane against Verratti, and Sauer will work against James Graham, the big scorer normally for the Shenango team.
Nice play. Real nice play.
Ryan Kaufman saved it off the foot.
Shadyside had a nice little give-and-go play there. Kane going to the hoop, but Sip wasn't able to get the ball to him. Ball was deflected. Did a good job of knocking it off the Shadyside player to get the turnover.
Lanigan, having scored 20 points in the semifinal game, a two-point win over Freeport, John Sikora's team. And there's Graham. He had 16. He needed that here. He's 1-for-8 from out there in three-point range so far tonight. The foul called on the rebound attempt against that Ryan Kaufman. That's his second.
Graham's a shooter. He averages 18 a game. He leads for them. He'll start warming up. That was a good idea, though. They set some screens for him along the baseline, trying to get him a free open standalone jumper.
And he is a natural shooter. He shoots 73% from the foul line, and he's been shooting the threes all season. You would think at some point he'll come around. Kane to the baseline, working against Graham. He pulls up with a jump shot. Kane doesn't average a lot of points, but he's been big in the playoffs for Shadyside. The senior with the held ball there, so it'll be Shenango basketball on the arrow. Lanigan outside, Shadyside man-to-man. Both teams played man-to-man the whole game. It looked appeared in the first half at some point that Shenango may have been in some type of a matchup zone, but it really turned out to be man.
Good looking shot.
Lanigan hit three-pointer.
And it wasn't bad defense either. He just got a quick release and pressure was pretty good. A nice shot.
His first three of the night, he has 10 points. And that's the second three for Shenango this half. They're only down four. Shadyside hasn't scored since that first foul shot. Sauer long, but not there's Damian McGill to clean things up from the backside.
Oh, you're right, over the backside. I thought it was. I thought it should have been a call. Looked like he jumped over the back, but he has such a height advantage.
Yeah. He's really been big in the playoffs for Shadyside. Only averages 11 points a game, but had a huge game in the semifinals with 21 points.
Well, there's no doubt about his talent. Watch him go over the back here.
Yep. I don't know.
Not too
contact?
Much.
Yeah,
just a little bit.
Just that long reach over the 6'2" Ryan Kaufman.
Probably a good no call.
There's a three-pointer for Lanigan. No, he's short. And Kane will come out of there running. 4-on-2. The Indians over and back. How did they? The only thing I can think in looking at that, you can correct me because I know you know the rules better, is trail foot never crossed. Does that mean anything?
I don't know. We'd have to take a look at it, but I thought he went over and back.
Yeah, well, I thought so, too.
But if you straddle the line,
that's what I mean.
I don't think you can come back. You have to go forward.
Go forward?
He straddled the line, came back, then went back.
Okay, well, that's
my question. It happened quickly, and I just don't think the refs got it.
Oh, how could they have missed it? That's why I'm wondering about the exact rule. Foul called against Damian McGill. His third for Shadyside. And they tell us from the truck, you can't tell what it was from the replay. Just ask, I don't know if they're listening. The trail foot and the ball, they're telling us, stayed behind the line, so
they're off.
Maybe that's why Sauer gets out on the fast break, and he's hacked pretty good by David Baratti. Working hard on that name here today. I apologize. 33-27, the Indians lead it. Sauer will go to the line for the first time. It's a 75% free throw shooter. He has 11 points in the game now with those two foul shots. 35-27, the Indians lead it. 4.5 minutes to play here in the third quarter, the AA championship of the WPIAL 1996.
Nice
great
play.
Move, huh?
Yeah, real great move. They cleared out a side, kind of made it look like they were setting a double screen on the baseline, but a real good move and no one from Shadyside helped. Everybody turned their back to the ball.
Yeah, Shane Lanigan now with 12 points for Shenango. As Kane got open and got the easy one for Shadyside right back.
That time that play worked. They ran that earlier and got a turnover off it, but that was a nice give and go again.
37-29, an 8-point lead for the Shadyside Indians.
Get him out of the lane!
After that quick three to start the half, Shenango's had trouble cutting into the lead. Delaney into the middle. He gets hacked. And they're going to call that on Carl Sipp. And it could have been on Damian McGill. And if it had been, that would have been his fourth. But look that way as you see number 50, Charlie Galo, waiting to check in, the 6'5 senior, or replace Damian McGill in the Shadyside lineup. Of course, we mentioned three fouls on Damian. And that's also three. Now they put that on Damian. Oh, wait a second. Oh, no, they haven't put the new one up. That's just one on Carl Sipp. Now we've got it in gear.
That's a nice offensive set that Shenango is running the last couple times down the floor. It's really a little two-man game on the right side of the floor, and they're setting a double screen for the other guard to come through. A lot of options off of that.
Number 12, Jarius Acey, the 5'9 freshman, back in for Shadyside, replacing Brian Wilkins. Kane working against Graham. Galo, look what I found.
Yeah, being in the right place at the right time.
His first basket of the game, and the Indians have a 39-30 lead.
It's a good call. I'm going to call that on Kane.
That's a first foul. And with that, as we take a look at this last drive by Chris Kane, Shadyside leading 39-30. We're going to a break, and Galo gets the bucket. WPIAL Championship Basketball being brought to you here on Prime Sports by Computer Tech, where you earn a specialized associate's degree in just 18 months. Lanigan gets it in for Shenango. Number 21, Matt Allison, now into the lineup. He's on the baseline. Verratti outside. Chick Lanigan. Graham 24 and 25, Ryan Delaney. Sets the Shenango lineup. 2:50 to play here in the third quarter. They're down nine. Could use a hoop. Graham into the lane. Hasn't had much luck outside.
Oh, nice move.
But he gets it in there, huh?
Great move.
Acey hasn't knocked away from him. The freshman actually showing some pretty good poise to be playing in the WPIAL championship. Look at this nice move here by James Graham, Dan.
All right, little scoop shot. It's the left arm, just pushing out a little bit, give himself a little room. Uses the left to shield the defender and scooped it up with his right hand.
Kane into the lane, dishes to Galo, but a little late on the dish. As a nice defensive play by Matt Allison to get in his way. That's two fouls against Chris Kane for Shadyside.
Real nice play by Matt, and that's good team defense. If someone beats their man, somebody steps in.
That's five there against the Indians. Yeah, right there, and he was there. That's five fouls against Shadyside this half. They still lead it by seven, but they get Shenango to the foul line, and they're a good foul shooting team. As things come down the stretch, that could be a factor. 2:10 to play third quarter. Barati's three-pointer was tipped by Sauer outside. Kane gets the steal. He stepped in front of Graham inside. Nice defensive play. Alex Sauer, the 5'11 junior for Shadyside. Those of you who saw our telecast last year might remember his 6'8 brother Pete. He played a little bit as a freshman at Stanford. Actually played a lot of a little bit this past season, despite an injured hand. Shenango, though, still down seven. Minute and a half approaching here in the third quarter. Opportunity here for the Wildcats. Lanigan looking for room. Graham for three.
That looked good.
He gets one. That's his second of the game, and hopefully that'll help him get started.
And Kane's done a great defensive job on him, but, you know, as the game goes on, you get real tired as a defender running through picks the whole game, and that's what he's doing. Nice dish.
Acey with the nice pass off. And Sipp the rebound and gets the foul against the on the rebound attempt.
I think that was on Graham.
Well, it's going to be on James Graham, his fourth for Shenango.
Really not a bad foul because Sip had an easy layup.
As 34, Jason Gergarina checks back in for Shenango, and number 10, Brian Wilkins, back in for Shadyside. Up to see if maybe they'll want to sit Graham a little bit here with 109 to play the third quarter and four fouls.
So it was a costly foul after all for Graham, if that is his fourth. But again, it saved them a bucket because, as I said, they had an easy layup.
Shenango's done a nice job getting Sip out of the game here in the second half. He's yet to score after 10 points, big points in the first half inside.
Well, Gill's been sitting down a lot. He's not in foul trouble, is he?
No, he's not in foul trouble.
I know he has a knee problem. I don't know if maybe that's bothering him, but he's been sitting down a long time.
Talking to Alex Housen, the head coach at Shadyside yesterday, seemed to take it. I mean, it hasn't really been a problem for McGill all season, although that's been a rumor all over the world.
Boom, Graham.
Two in a row, and it's a two-point, it's a one-point game. James Graham from three-point range heating up his third of the night, 39-38 game. Shadyside could use a bucket. Halo in the lane. AC sets it up outside. Wilkins will work on the wing. Halo inside, tries to go low. But a good play by Delaney.
Nice pass.
Lanigan ahead of the pack, and Sauer got back to knock it out of bounds.
Yeah, nice play by Sauer because it was a clean strip. A beautiful lead pass to Lanigan breaking down the floor.
24 seconds left. Lanigan.
Clean strip, and that was a good call.
Yeah, tried to inbound. Right, good play.
24 seconds, down one. I think I'd play for the last one here.
See what Coach Bill McNeese wants to do. Delaney inside. He'll go up and another block for Carl Sipp, his fourth of the game.
Well, if Delaney had it back again, he probably should have used his left hand because he went up with his right that made it easy to block.
Sipp knocked that out as Lanigan tried to force it under to Delaney.
You know, Kane's sitting on the bench right now, and they got to go back to Graham because he can get free, but he's wide open. I could have made that. Nobody watched Delaney.
He
was just standing there. It wasn't like he came off a pick or anything. He was just wide open.
And Shenango has their first lead in quite a while. 40-39. They scored 11 straight points. Sip has him stripped, and there could have been a foul there, but that's going to be the end of the third quarter. But the Shenango Wildcats, the one-point lead, as you see the Shenango fans celebrating here in the AA Championship at the A.J. Palumbo Center. Ready for the final 8 minutes here of the Class AA Championship. We've had two good ones so far. We got a one-point game here.
Well, Sean, the story of the third quarter is Shenango started taking better shots and making them, and it was that simple. And from the time McGill sat down, they took control. They rattled off 11 in a row, and now they have the lead.
They have McGill and Kane back in there. Shadyside down one. There's Chris Kane. Davey McGill wears double zero. Kane a little trouble into the lane. Swooped it out. Can Sauer save it? He does. So Brian Wilkins will set it up offensively. McGill just inside the three-point line, and Kane on the backside rebound. A loose ball is going to go to Shenango.
And I think if you're Shenango, you'll give them that shot all night long because, one, that's not to his strength, and two, that keeps him away from the offensive board.
And two more Shenango three-point shooters have come into the game, and Verratti and Kaufman, they're looking to light it up here with a one-point lead and 7:20 to play.
They're in a box right now, Sean. Shadyside on defense. They're in a box and one. Kane is playing Graham.
And Kaufman recognized it and shouted it to his friends. We'll see what they do to set things up. Graham outside. Shadyside changed their defense. Either that or Wilkins moved over on Graham.
Now they're staying in the box.
Right. Yeah, you're right.
Now they've gone man-to-man. They're changing. Shenango's changing their offense. They're changing again. Good control by Shenango. Recognize the defense,
huh?
And then run your offense. They should be in no hurry right now.
I would imagine they ran against this a few times during the year.
I would think so. They look like they recognized it right away.
Delaney inside, and he gets fouled, but does not get the roll.
Sean, third Third quarter stats, team leaders in scoring for Shadyside. Sip with 10, he didn't score in the third quarter. Sauer with 11. For Shenango, Graham and Delaney each with 11. Lanigan with 12, nice balance.
Coach Bill McNeese with the timeout. You are watching WPIAL Championship Basketball here on Prime Sports. It's being brought to you by Computer Tech, where you earn a specialized associate's degree in just 18 months. Dan, with the one-point lead, Coach McNeese called this timeout. So I know you're trying to maybe listen in and check out the diagram in the huddle.
I think it was a good timeout. He recognized that Shadyside might be switching up their defenses a little bit. He just wants to make sure everybody on their team is on the same page as to what offense they're going to run against a particular defense.
After a rough start in the first half, Graham now has 11 points in the game. That's 8 of them coming in this third quarter. So that's a big part of that 11-point run they made to end the quarter and get the lead here over the Shadyside Academy Indians. Coach Housen, Alex Housen, Dean Cartsonis, the assistant and former star at Shadyside, they came up with that box and one on the last timeout. What do you do defensively? Do you maybe go back to it or stick with man?
I stick with Kane on Graham. I think he's been doing a pretty good job. Graham got free a couple times, but for the most part, Kane's done a real good job against him. I just stay straight man. I don't think it's to the point right now where they have to go with a junk defense.
Ryan Delaney's at the foul line, shooting 2. The foul was called against Shadyside's Chris Kane. He now has 3. 6.5 minutes to go. 2 straight to 42-39. Shenango lead.
That's 13 in a row they've run off.
Yeah, the Indians were up 8, real comfortable, but you have to wonder now. I'm sure they've been through this before. They blew a 15-point lead in the quarterfinals against Carlinton to win that, and came back to win that one in overtime.
Nice day.
Kane down the middle, the pass from Wilkins, but Indians having trouble finishing the play.
It's going to be Shadyside.
McGill was hacked pretty hard, I think, or is that a jump ball?
That's
call?
A jump ball, I think he's calling.
Graham, I guess, had a hold of it, laying on the floor.
That's Shenango ball.
Shadyside had it to start the quarter, I think.
Yeah, you're right.
I guess so. There's Graham for 3 more. Hard off the rim, but he gets his own rebound and a reach foul called. It's going to go, I believe, against Chris Kane, and that'll be 4. Nope. Call it on Brian Wilkins for Shadyside. And that puts Shenango into the 1-1, and we talked about that a little earlier. With guys who can shoot the ball like they can. Not a good situation for the Indians. Graham's a 73% shooter.
One of the other things we talked about at halftime was points in the paint. If you recall at halftime, Shadyside had 18 points, almost over half their point total in the paint. They haven't gotten that in the second half. They need to get back into the paint, get it into McGill, get it into Sip, and let them go to work. Because even if they miss, I think they can dominate on the offensive board and get the follow-up.
13 points for James Graham. It's a 44-39 lead for the Shenango Wildcats. 6 minutes to play. Straight points for Shenango.
Block.
Jarius Acey, number 12, the freshman, tried to end that streak, but couldn't break it off, and he'll match up with Lanigan. The Wildcats in control with a 5-point lead, 5:40 to play.
The Shenango team is a very well-coached team. They are very disciplined. They run their offense.
Graham for 3.
Time Kane wasn't on him, and Sauer got either, it must have been a pick or something, but Sauer ended up on Graham and gave him too much room. I mean, if he's across half court, you better get on him.
He has 16, averages 18, and James had yards. Called against Carl Sipp.
Sean Delaney has really come up big in this fourth quarter. He hit the 2 free throws. He had the block the last time down the floor, and that time he picks up a charge.
Yep. And Graham is providing the offensive power for Shenango. They lead it 47-39 and are in control of the basketball.
And again, that's team defense. Someone got beat and someone helped out and stepped in and drew the charge. A little trap right here.
Just 2 fouls against Shadyside's Carl Sippen. The Indians forced the turnover.
And that was a good coaching move by Shadyside. They caught Shenango sleeping, a little trap. No one recognized it for Shenango. Get the ball in the paint.
Kane down the baseline. A little short as he tried to battle up. Look at that. Sip comes out of there with it. And the foul's going to be called on number 20, David Baratti. Will Shenango. Just 16 fouls, though, so Shadyside will inbound. Well, the foul called on top of
that. You see the run, 18-0 run for Shenango. Really, it started about midway third quarter.
That's a big three
there.
This game.
Tell you what, Chris Kane is not a pretty player. He's like a runaway train, but boy, is he effective. He does a lot of little things.
Well, he played a great deal in last year's championship loss to Stowe Rocks.
It's a trap again.
And he has been big in the playoffs this year. Sauer, the good luck to Jerry Stacy. He's in the book on the scoreboard, and he'll go to the line for another.
And Shenango needs a timeout because this defense has really confused him.
It's the kind of tough that the big guys at Shadyside has. They can force bad passes. And it's a three-point game with AC at the line when we come back. Shenango 47, Shadyside 44.
And we're back in the WPIAL AA final, Shenango 47. Shadyside 44. Sean, I think that timeout for Shenango was to address the change in defense by Shadyside, this 1-2-2 trap defense. Shenango has been attacking it with one guard. You need two guards out front to swing the ball. Let's see if they make an adjustment.
AC a little short with the
There's
foul
Kane.
Shot, but Kane again. And that's gonna be Shenango ball out off. Chris Kane, a good hustle though, on the attempt at the rebound. We'll see how Shenango handles it, or does Shadyside get another? They pulled it off.
I think Shadyside pulled it off, and yeah, you know, half the key to that is a surprise.
Yeah, they'll surprise them with it, I guess, next time, huh? Graham from the baseline. The three-pointer not there for him that time, and the loose ball bounced to Damian McGill. He averages 7 rebounds a game. That was an easy one for him. But he anticipated where it would come off. Kane, great drive, but not the finish. And Delaney, a huge rebound for Shenango.
Three and a half back to a straight man-to-man. Little spread offense here.
Under 3.5 minutes to play.
Trying to keep the middle of the floor open. If someone can beat their man, they go.
Kane almost got his hand on that ball, but missed. And they'll swing it back out and set it up again. Don't take time off, they don't mind. Leading by 3, the Wildcats and Shenango.
Really what Shenango should do is put Graham in the corner because that's the defender who's helping out. There's the open shot right there.
It's a 3.
That's exactly where he should be. Because when the guy in the middle is beating their man, that defender's sagging in the middle to help. And there's the kick out pass, and the guy in the corner is going to be open.
He's made 5 of those 3 tonight after a rough start. He went 1-for-8 first, and he drilled 4 more this half.
He's a scorer, though. Didn't bother him a bit. Every time he had an open shot, he kept taking it. He didn't force his shots. He just waited for good shots.
50-46. Shadyside Indians trail. They need a hoop. AC.
Nice shot.
The freshman has got 4.
Nice move.
4-point game, 50-46.
David, ready to help.
It's a trap.
They get it up to Graham in the corner. They'll go down the baseline.
Charge. And that's 5, isn't it?
Carl Sipp, yep, that'll be 5 fouls.
Boy, that hurts.
Against James Graham, and a tough guy to lose down the stretch of the championship game.
Well,
Carl Sipp.
You're not kidding him, because he carried him in the second half.
Pretty nice defensive play by Carl Sipp.
Excellent.
They anticipated here, Dan. Oh, there's the three-point attempt, his last 3 of the game. He leaves the game with 19 big points, huge points. 16 of those 19 in the second half. The Shadyside will have it here, down 4 with 2:14 to play. 18 fouls against Shenango. Number 34, Jason Delgarino. 6'1" senior replaces James Graham. And Coach McNeese wants a timeout here with 2:14 to play in the basketball game. You are watching. He has been big, and we knew he would get him. He got 19. We talked about it. He averages 18 a game, 19 a game, so he's right at his average. So an average game for James Graham here. Seemed like a great second half, but it was an average game. That's the kind of player he has been for the Shenango Wildcats.
The other thing that might be a factor down the stretch on is I think Shenango only has one timeout left. They burned a few, burned another one there. Shadyside has three timeouts left. There's still a lot of time, 2:14 left on the clock. I would expect for Shenango to ice the ball a little bit next time they get it, try and get to the foul line.
And Alex Housen is sticking with his freshman, Jarius Acey, number 12 at the point. I guess those two hoops have really helped his value to the Shadyside team. Kane misses the shot and a nice loose ball rebound, but it goes out of bounds on the near sideline. It'll be Shadyside basketball.
Sip got away with a smack there. I thought there was a foul, and I think Lanigan thought there was also.
He couldn't control it. Look at Acey, he wants a three. Not there, and Sauer couldn't grab the rebound.
He's
Delaney.
Got a ton of rebounds.
Yeah, he's really been all over the place. Ryan Delaney inside, played a real strong game so far against the bigger Shadyside forwards. And there's a foul called on Damian McGill for Shadyside, and that's his fourth. 1:43 to play. Nine against the Indians. So Lanigan will shoot 1-1.
And I think that's exactly what Shenango wants right now. You know, foul us. We'll go to the line. We'll win the game at the line. We have confidence in our free throw shooting.
62% shooter for the year. points, 3-for-3 from the foul line. 52-46. Shenango leads it. Shadyside with the basketball. Kane three.
He's just someone you love to have on your team. He'll drive you nuts, but then he comes through when he has to. The foul is called on Kane for the reach.
15 points for Chris Kane in the game. Two big threes here in the fourth quarter. That's four fouls against Chris. Two shots for Gergarina, 10 fouls against Shadyside. Shenango has shot well at the line here tonight. This afternoon, I guess. McGill clears it, and here come the Indians. Acey, the freshman. McCain in the corner, trouble handling it, but gets a hold of it.
Look out.
Baseline. Ball knocked loose. Who hit it last? Lanigan gets it and falls out of bounds. Called the timeout before he hit the floor. Shenango basketball and Shenango timeout with 1:01 to play. I guess you picked that up watching TV, Dan. Well, it would have been something if they had been out of them.
Well, that's what I was saying. I was wondering if that was ever going to hurt them.
Yeah.
Because with Shadyside trapping all over the place, you like to have a couple timeouts for just a situation like that, just out of desperation. Now they're out of timeouts, but they have the ball and a four-point lead. They're in the double bonus. Everything's going their way right now.
Sure is. 53-49. Shenango leads it as you look at Coach McNeese in the huddle. Trying to map out the final 61 seconds of this Class A WPIAL championship basketball game. Don't dare go away. We've got a great 1A championship coming up. 6 o'clock scheduled start, tip off. The Upper St. Clair Panthers against Franklin Regional. You see Alex Housen and the Shadyside Indians there in their huddle. Down four.
They basically have to foul. I assume they'll put some pressure on Shenango, try and get some traps. But if Shenango gets across half court and they have control of the ball, they're going to have to go and foul somebody.
Well, the problem there is that Kane has four fouls, and I guess that's why he's out of the game right now. Shenango's 11 for 13 shooting fouls in this game. There's a steal for Brian Wilkins, but he couldn't keep it in bounds.
He made a great steal, but he just couldn't get control of the ball.
54 ticks left. Lanigan gets it in. Kaufman and gets it back. He's double teamed. Goes around to AC. Imagine AC will be the man they want to commit the foul if anybody does from Shadyside. And there it is. If he went for the steal,
I don't think Lanigan's the guy with a foul, though.
But with 39 seconds left, they're running out of options.
They were. I thought they'd go after Delaney when he got the ball in the pivot. But he was able to kick it out in a hurry. Didn't give him the opportunity.
Yeah, just a 61% foul shooter, Delaney is. But still pretty fair. I mean, when you're shooting any more, it's unbelievable. 61% is pretty good.
Yeah.
Unless you play for Blackhawk. Those guys last night were unbelievable.
They are.
This is going to be awful tough for Shadyside. Down 54-49. Lanigan is coming up big. When they need him, and he gets the roll there.
Never foul the point guard.
Four straight foul shots for Shane Lanigan. As I said, just a 62% shooter, but he makes them when they need him. Kane tried the three. And Lanigan, yeah, that's going to be big. Under 30 seconds. And Carl Sipp's going to get that foul, reaching around the back. With 23 seconds left on the clock.
What a nice scene. Shenango had a great turnout today. Team we haven't seen around the WPIAL finals. It's really nice to see a new team experience this in a community who hasn't had a WPIAL championship experience this right now.
Absolutely.
This is a very well coached team. They're a good team, but they're awfully well coached also.
There's the story, 55-49 with 23 ticks left in the game. See if we can hear what Phil McNeese is calling his team.
It's real simple. Don't foul and let him throw up a bomb. Get a hand in someone's face. Don't foul.
Guy Kaufman. Hey, you go to the ball. Okay, I'm with Shane here. I'm with Delaney there. Baratti and Gergen. We're one forward line. You understand? No, I don't know. Hey, Delaney, I want an inside pick for Shane. Inside pick for Shane. Baratti, you go deep. Gergen, you come back. Kaufman, bounce off his leg. I got no juice. Get it in, protect the ball, help the guy against the trap. They get any timeout?
They have two. They have two. We have none.
It's going to be number 34, Jason Gergerina, at the foul line. Carl Sipp with just three fouls, but he makes these, Dan. There's not much Shadyside can do here in the final 23. Big if.
Stranger things have happened.
Yeah, that's for sure. Indians down six. We'll need a couple of threes to force overtime. And they're going to need three possessions.
That was a big one. You need to get one of them. Now you just want to stay between your man and the basket.
Kane wants to force the three. He does. Double pump. Oh, that almost went down the hoop. But Lanigan the rebound. And Davey McGill's going to foul out of the game for Shadyside. 7 points in the contest for Davey McGill. As he leaves with 12 seconds left in the game, and Shenango celebrated. A 56-49 lead in their WPIAL Class AA Championship.
Unfortunately for Shady Shaw, they're going to come up short again this year. They
2 years in a row.
Rocks. They won the states last year.
Yeah,
so
they bounced.
Ease the pain a little bit.
I would think just a tad.
And they'll be in the state playoffs again.
17 points for Shane Lanigan. So the two big guys for Shenango have done it here this afternoon. With James Graham leaving the game with 19 and Lanigan up to 17, right at their averages for the season. Alex Sauer had a big first half for Shadyside, but that three's not there. And that's it for Shenango Wildcats. WPIAL champions.
That's a happy group of people there. Well deserved.
25-1. Shadyside drops to 21-5.
The Shadyside team showing a lot of class, immediately goes over, shakes their hands, congratulates them. That shows a lot.
Saw the face of a real disappointed Damian McGill on the bench there. Just a second to go. His second time he's been through this. Well, we're going to go to a break and we'll be back. George Savarese with post-game interviews with the victorious Bill McNeese and the Wildcats. We're back here at the A.J. Palumbo Center where the Shenango Wildcats have just defeated Shadyside 57-49 to win a WPIAL AA championship. And George Savarese has the victorious coach Bill McNeese with him courtside. Let's throw it over to George. We're having problems with that, Dan. What a game it was for Shenango to win the game.
Well, I'll tell you what, Sean, the thing that was most impressive was Graham, who struggled in the first half, basically picked this team up and carried them in. And even when he went out with 1:41 left in the game, Shenango didn't panic. I don't think they scored a hoop from the field the rest of the way out, but they were successful in getting to the free throw line. And they got their points from the free throw line. And even despite the fact they lost Graham, they kept their composure and were able to bring the championship home.
That they did. And we've got George and Coach McNeese now. We've got the courtside James Graham waiting as well. So let's throw it to George. Take it away, man.
Okay, we're here with the coach of the victorious Shenango Wildcats. Coach, it was a great game, especially dramatic coming down the stretch. Your team was able to come from behind. What was the difference between the first half and the second half, and why were you able to enjoy the kind of success you had late in the game?
I think the second half we got our offense rolling a lot better. First half, Shadyside did a great job of defending us, and we didn't get the kind of shots we wanted. At halftime, we talked about getting back to our offensive game plan and stepping up a little bit on defense. And the kids did both of those things, and I think that was a factor in the second half.
It seemed like in the second half, you guys were able to shut down McGill and Sip a lot better as well. They were able to get a lot of points early.
I think a lot of that credit not only goes to the big guys inside, but to our guards. Our guards stepped up the pressure, made it harder for the guys to pass the ball inside.
Late in the game, were you hoping that you could get a lead, maybe get into a situation where you'd be forced to the foul line? Your team shoots so well at the foul line.
Yeah, we really were hoping to be able to have a lead with about 4 minutes to go, and we thought we'd win the game. Because we felt with guards like this guy right next to me that we could spread the floor, handle the ball, and knock down our fouls.
Were you worried when James Graham fouled out? Did you think, oh my God, we got 2 minutes left on the clock?
I sure was. James Graham belongs on the floor. For 3 years, he has just done one heck of a job for this program, and I need him out of here. I didn't like when he came by me. But God bless him, he came through big second half. Everybody else picked it up for him, and we held it down the stretch.
It seems like this is a team, obviously, that just doesn't go to one guy when it comes time to deliver. You've got 3 or 4 players who can score for you in the clutch, and that's especially what happened for you today.
It really is. It's a team effort. It has been all year long. These are the most unselfish kids I've ever had. Jimmy will knock down threes for a while. Shane Lanigan over here is the best point guard in WPIL, and he did a great job directing the show. And Ryan Delaney once again did a yeoman's job inside along with Kaufman and Allison and Verratti.
Bill McNeese, congratulations. Good luck to you in the States.
Thank you very much.
Let's bring in some of your players. Let's talk to James Graham, the star from Shenango. Jim, looked like you were able to really turn it on in the second half. You only had about 3 points with about 3 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Then you exploded. You had a couple of big three-point shots. What happened in the second half?
A lot of the Shadyside pressure, it opened things up when Shane found me in the corner. They all ran at Shane, which opened the three-point shot up for me. And I just do my job and I make it.
When you were coming against them late in the game, did you expect them to start doing something different? They tried to press you, I think, late in the game. They all of a sudden were going with the trap. What were they trying to do? Were they just trying to maybe get you off your game a little bit at the end?
Shane's obviously our best ball handler, and they tried taking him out of the game, but the rest of us, our guards, stepped it up. We just do our job out there. It's a team effort today.
What about the crowd? Was that the loudest crowd you've played before?
We got the best team in the WPIL and also the best fans. That's all I got to say. They're great.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Bring in Shane Lanigan. Congratulations. When James went out of the game, when he fouled out with a couple minutes left to go, did you think, oh, my God, now we've got to come against
him? I was nervous because it happened earlier in the season. That's the only game we lost. But we stepped it up. We just pulled through.
Were you worried early in the game when Shadyside had so much success underneath the boards with guys like McGill and Sip?
No, not really. They had good success under the boards, but I knew our jump shots weren't falling. So I knew they'd fall sooner or later. So I wasn't real worried. And James, he stepped up big.
In the States, you guys take a lesson out of this game. I mean, obviously you're playing before big crowds now. You're used to the pressure. Does winning a game like this under such pressure help you guys keep your composure down the stretch?
Yeah, I think so. I think being down 9 points, it wasn't good at the time, but it might be now because we kept our composure and pulled through.
Congratulations. Heck of a game for you.
Thank you.
Good luck in the state championship. That's Shane Lanigan, his point guard for Shenango. An outstanding effort as Shadyside loses for the second consecutive year in the WPALs. Last year they lost to Stowe Rocks, this year to Shenango. Shenango wins the title, caps off a great season for them. They're now 25-1 and going to the state championship. We'll be back right here from the Palumbo Center with the WPIAL championship. Actually, let's just send it back to Sean and Dan. Guys?
Okay.
All right, we're back here. Thanks, Georgia. Got Alex Housen, courtside. You could just run down the final leaders, scoring leaders of tonight's game.
Sure, Sean. For Shadyside, Kane led with 15, Sauer with 11, Sip with 10. He went scoreless in the second half. McGill with 7. That was tough. For Shenango, leading scores, Graham with 19, Lanigan with 17, Delaney with 13.
Big 13 points, and we'll have the whole team stats set up here for you. And Delaney did a heck of a job in shutting down Carl Sip in the second half. But as we mentioned, George Mell is with Alex Housen, the head coach from Shadyside Academy. He's yours, George. Take it away.
Okay, here we are with Alex Housen, a coach from Shadyside Academy. Alex, it was a great game, but boy, you have to stop a lot of weapons from Shenango.
Yeah, you do. They have 3 key ball players, and they can all score. Delaney's tough inside, and Lanigan and Graham are tough outside, and I thought Chris Kane did a very good job on Graham tonight. A couple times in the second half, though, we didn't help him out, and he got a couple of key 3-pointers when they were making their comeback. But it was a great basketball game. Shenango's a great team, and I'm not ashamed of our kids. Our kids played very hard. We had a great season, and hey, we're still in the States.
And last year, the same thing happened. You came to the WPIAL Finals, you lost to Stowe Rocks, but then you were able to manage to win the state championship. So that's got to be a nice precedent.
No, it is a nice precedent. You know, I think last year we got the better seed, finishing second. You don't like to do that, but I really think we did. You know, we have a week to prepare. We've got 4 games to get to Hershey. So our kids won't give up. They didn't give up today, so we'll be ready for the playoffs.
You've got a lot of seniors. Obviously, this has to be disappointing, being that it's their second time here and losing, but they played a great game. But what happened in the second half? They were able to really contain Shenango through most of the game. You were up by 9 points at one point. What happened?
Well, they made some defensive adjustments at halftime. They really shut down our offense in the second half. And, you know, we only scored 19 points in the third and fourth quarter. So you got to give their coaching staff and the kids a lot of credit, because we were having a very hard time, number one, getting the ball inside. And, you know, we don't like to rely on the 3, but at the end we had to, and they weren't very good shots. And so, you know, but they shut our offense down, and they did a very nice job of doing it. But, you know, we played a good defensive ball game. I'm not ashamed of our kids at all. And we've hustled all year long. And, you know, you're going to run up against teams like this and games like this. And, hey, you just have to rebound. That's all.
Well, it was a tremendous season for you and a great game. And good luck in the state championship, defending your state championship.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
That's Alex Hauser, the head coach at Shadyside Academy. Now let's head back to Sean and Dan, as Shadyside loses for the second consecutive year. And behind me, Shenango is celebrating their championship as they become the AA WPIAL champions. Now let's head back to Sean and Dan to recap the game.
We're back, George. Thanks very much. Some thoughtful words from a coach who has been this route before, and they got a chance. So the last time they went this route, they finished up pretty darn good with a win in Hershey, Pennsylvania. Dan, let's take a look at those final team stats and wrap this game completely. Double-A championship won by the Shenango Wildcats.
Shenango improved their shooting percentage. They were about 30% at halftime. They got it up to around 40, and Shadyside dipped down. They were 56% at the first half.
Yeah.
And again, they went down to 43%. I think that had more to do with shot selection than anything. They got away from going in the paint, as we talked about.
You know, the difference is 6 points there and 3 point shots. A big difference as Graham came up real big in the second half for Shenango to win the game. And they did a heck of a job on the boards, did Shenango. Delaney was enormous in there. As you see the rebounding.
Yeah, and that was the other thing we pointed out at halftime, Sean, was that Shadyside had a pretty distinctive rebounding edge, but Shenango did a good job in the second half, out-rebounded them, had the advantage for the game.
All right, we'll get ready. We'll take a break, and we'll be back in a couple minutes here with John Duffy and John Sikora with more on this game. So as we said, it's Shenango winning the AA championship. And of course, John knows a lot about both these teams, and he can give you his ideas when we get back to the A.J. Palumbo Center on the campus of Duquesne University in 2 minutes. Count them out.